In this video, we are going to walk through the process of reading and writing tags with the ThingMagic Universal Reader Assistant Program, also known as URA. If you have successfully downloaded the URA program and connected to your reader, then we will begin on the URA homepage. Once you have connected to your reader, click Read and place one or more RFID tags within range of your reader's antenna. Five columns will appear on your datasheet. The pound column, which is the order in which the tags were read. The EPC column, which is the memory area of the tag. The timestamp column, which is the last time the tags were read. The RSSI column, which is the received signal strength of the tag measured in decibels. The closer to zero the RSSI is, the stronger your signal. You can test this by moving tags closer and farther away from the reader. And lastly, the read count column, which is the amount of times that a tag has been read. You can alter the read power in the performance tuning section between 5 and 31.5 decibels. Read power is directly related to read range, so the higher the read power, the longer the read range. You can also change the way that the tags appear on your datasheet by clicking Write EPC on the top of your screen. Select either First Tag to Respond or the tag that you previously selected, then select how you would like the EPC to be displayed on the datasheet. Then simply press Read and make your changes. When encoding RFID tags, you will need to make sure that you always use 24 hexadecimal characters. This means that you must use 24 characters that are between A and F and 0 and 9. Once the tag is successfully encoded, you will notice that the changes will immediately be seen on the datasheet. That concludes our tutorial of the ThingMagic Universal Reader Assistant program. We discussed how to read and write tags, as well as some of the different settings and features that the Universal Reader Assistant program offers for your application. For more information on all things RFID, check out our blog or our RFID resources page. And as always, if you have any questions at all, send us an email or give us a call.